Well, good evening, friends. Welcome to Friarside Chat. I'm your deep fat friar, Pastor Andrew. This week, friends, we have someone joining us because I've found it so difficult in the world that we live in today to know which side is right. Various opinions. Do I agree with this person or that person? Do I stand up or sit down? Do I speak out or stay silenced? I'll tell you, it's almost as though the element in this deep fat fryer is burning out. So, tonight we're joined by a man who says that he understands the duplicity of struggles. His name, Mr. Flappé. Philippe Flappé. He's joining us all the way from Paris. Mr. Flappé, are you there? Are you there, Mr. Flappé?
Well, good evening, fire! It is so good to be on your program! I am always watching you while I am flipping back and forth between the other programs.
Yeah, he's always flipping back and forth between the programs. Because, well, what do you expect for a guy whose name is Flip Flop?
My name is not Flip Flop. It is Philippe Flappé. I am the French man, and you know that.
Well, gentlemen, I didn't know we were going to be having two guests tonight. It's a bonus. Mr. Flappé, would you please let your other guest introduce himself?
Yeah. I'm Flip Flop. I'm this guy's other side.
You are not my other side? I am the only side. I'm a true Frenchman. You're not French. You are not even a French door before you were made.
You're not French. The closest thing you've ever been to being French was that you ordered a large French fry at McDonald's.
How dare you! I am the Frenchiest of the French men! I know all of the French words, like baguette, escargot, ravioli. And besides, I am from Paris!
You're from Paris, Illinois.
And you're from my mother's dresser!
Gentlemen, gentlemen, please. Is what you're telling me that you're two people trying to work with one mind and one desire? That has to be incredibly difficult.
I'll say. Have you ever tried to order a cheeseburger with a Frenchman? You should have seen the kid's face at Burger King when he asked for a Whopper with Goodyear cheese.
That's Gruyere, you fool! Can I help it if as a Frenchman, I do not want just the American cheese?
Wow. Seeing the two of you in action reminds me of a verse in James chapter 1, verse 8. It says that a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. I would certainly say we're seeing some evidence of that. You know, though, if the friar is to be honest, sometimes I struggle with that myself. I know what God's word says. I know what I should do. But I also know that there are opinions of me from other people. And sometimes I try to live to both of those, both God's opinion and man's opinion. When I do that, it only leads to confusion and heartache and double-mindedness.
I think you are the correct one, Friar Fatman. This fool over here, he's always confused.
I'm confused? I'm confused? This man thinks that soccer is football. He thinks retreat means victory. And he thinks snails are food.
Well, I guess you could... Wait. You eat snails? Ewy. Gentlemen, it's been great having you on the show. But I think we've been through enough together. Perhaps we should just call it a night.
Yes, yes, yes. You are correct. We should be going. We will be competing in an arm wrestling competition this evening.
You mean I'll be competing? You'll be losing.
Ha! You beat me at arm wrestling? I scoff in your general direction. Scoff, scoff, scoff!
Well, there you have it, friends. Just like the Bible says, a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. You know, I know that it can be difficult at times not to struggle with being double-minded, worried about what people might think. But this week, will you join me, your deep fat friar, in keeping our minds on Jesus, focusing on him and what his word says? Because the Bible says that when we do that, we will understand true rest. Thanks so much for joining me this week, friends, on another of our Friarside Chats. I'm your deep fat friar, Pastor Andrew. We'll see you next time.